So this year we are celebrating SR 75th Independence Day as the completion of 74 glorious years of Indian independence. 74 years of Indian independence. So on the day of 14th August midnight 1947, the first Prime Minister of India, it announced as a declaration of Indian independence with a famous historical speech which is known as Jai Dhingra. What is the name of a dash speech which was given by the Pandit Nehru in a constituent assembly through which it declared India is now onwards as an independent country? Very good. Tryst with destiny. So that historical speech given by the Pandit Nehru in a constituent assembly, that constituent assembly which framed in 1946 for the formation of an Indian constitution, that constitution which enforced and on 1950, through which as a declaration of Indian Republic. So Indian independence, it was as the effort, combined effort of a large number of freedom strugglers which sacrificed themselves for a nation, which are known as the moderates and the radicalist leaders of a Congress and revolutionaries. Can anybody give me the names of a five revolutionaries, like as a Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad? Subhash Chandra Bose, it was a radicalist leader. Okay, Kartar Singh Sarabhai, yes, you. Lala Lajpat Rai, it was a radicalist leader of a Congress. Revolutionaries who sacrificed themselves for a nation, which were hanged and killed by the Britishers for their acts. They opted a way of violence. Sukhdev, okay, one. No? Only two. Still two names are given. No? Udham Singh, very good. Which took as a revenge of a Jallianwala Bagh massacre by killing of a General Dyer. Three done. Two more. Who composed that poem of Sarfaroshi Ki Tamanna? No? It was a composition of a Hindu person. Yes. Very good boy. Ram Prasad Bismil. Ashfaq Ullah Khan, Batukeshwar Dutt. So such kind of a dignitaries which contributed in a Indian freedom struggle for independence of India. Independence of India, which declared on a 14th August 1947 with the partition of a country. That partition which was signed, their draft was signed by the last Viceroy of India, Lord Mountbatten. It was sent by the Britishers. By the existing ruler of England, Sir Clement Attlee. It was the existing prince of England, which sent the Lord Mountbatten to sign as a declaration of partition of the country, which was based on which idea? What was the idea behind the partition of a country? Good girl. Very good girl. Religion. Muslim areas separated from the non-Muslim areas. That's why the India divided into three parts. So Muslim areas, two of the areas which lies in the eastern sides of a country and the western sides of a country. So that's why India divided into three parts, eastern Pakistan, western Pakistan, and mainland of India. Clear? So this was a demand which was raised by the Muslim League, their leader, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, which is known as the father of the Pakistan. So let me move towards again, Indian independence. Indian independence. So at the time of independence, before after independence, they're all over the India, which includes as existing Bangladesh, existing Pakistan, and existing India. It was divided into the how many total number of princely states? 500. Amritpal? 500. Then Mehul Bajaj? 8. Then you next, why? Any numeral? How many total number of princely states existed in a colonial India? Shantanu. Then Namneet. 5. Jaya. Agar hum 5, 8, 9, 7, ye figure keh rahe hain. After the independence, when the Pakistan and Bangladesh separated from India, 14 states were formed. How can we say as a 4, 5, 7, 9 figure? Then 7, then you. So more than 500, these were the 562 states were there. So when Britishers, they left the country, they declared as a partition of a country on 14th August 1947 as a day of a formation of a Pakistan. At that time, the Britishers not marked any of the territorial boundaries. All the boundaries, all the areas, these were the freed from a British control. But the Britishers not marked any of a territorial boundary. Means modern map of India, it was not came into existence. Due to the endless efforts of a Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, to which as a he tried to make as a treaties with the Indian rulers to merge their territories under the Indian dominance. Because of their efforts in an Indian map, we know that person as Iron Man of India. Iron Man of India. 562 states were there. And just after the independence, at first, 14 states were formed on the basis of?
Language.
Very good. Linguistic basis. In India, the idea of a division of a states is based upon a linguistic. Still, as the, all these 29 states are formed on such basis, linguistic basis. So any questions related with Indian independence? Anybody want to ask? Ek din pehle mili thi, 14th August 1947. Pakistan independent on 14th and India in 15th. हाँ जी पार्टीशन पहले बंटवारा हुआ ना पार्टीशन हुआ पार्टीशन डॉक्यूमेंट साइन किया गया एंड नॉन मुस्लिम एरियाज मुस्लिम एरिया सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम द नॉन मुस्लिम एरियाज पॉपुलेशन स्टार्टेड एज देयर माइग्रेशन बंटवारा जब हुआ तो फाइनली ऑन 15 अगस्त 1947 तत्कालिक प्रधानमंत्री पंडित नेहरू जी उन्होंने लाल किले की प्राचीर के ऊपर चढ़ के उद्घोषणा करते हुए कहा भारत आज से स्वतंत्र है दैट कंट्री विच विल बी नॉट हैज फॉलोड द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस बाय द अदर पीपल विल यूज देयर सिविल फ्रीडम्स फॉर एग्जांपल एज एट द टाइम ऑफ ब्रिटिश एज दे पास एज अ सेडिशन एक्ट इन 1870 विच अफेक्टेड एज सिविल फ्रीडम्स पीपल दे कैन एक्सप्रेस अगेंस्ट ऑफ द अथॉरिटीज 1870 एज इक्विवेलेंट टू द सेडिशन एक्ट ब्रिटिशर्स इनएक्टेड अनदर लॉ Another law against of which the Jallianwala Bagh massacre occurred. Which law? Which law? Which year? 1819. Anybody? Sedition Act passed in 1870. Britishers enacted the another act. In which the civil freedoms they affected in India. Civil 1919 mein act pass hua tha. Rowlatt Act pass hua tha, jiske against Jallianwala Bagh massacre hua. Because according to the Rowlatt Act, a black act, not in any of a public place, not more than the two individuals they can stand. If a person has standing in a public place, police can arrest and without trial, it can send behind the bars. Usko jail kiya ja sakta tha, case chalaya ja sakta tha. ठीक है ना ये रॉयल एक्ट था सो एज पर देयर इज अनदर एक्ट व्हिच वाज इनएक्टेड बाय द ब्रिटिशर्स टू व्हिच दे रिस्ट्रिक्टेड द फ्रीडम ऑफ अ प्रेस वर्नाकुलर प्रेस एक्ट पास्ड इन व्हिच ईयर वर्नाकुलर प्रेस एक्ट अगर कोई न्यूज़पेपर रेडियो चैनल ब्रिटिश पॉलिसीज को क्रिटिसाइज करता है पब्लिकली देन दे फंक्शनिंग इट विल अफेक्टेड बाय द ब्रिटिश ऑफिशियल्स कंपनी ऑफिशियल्स व्हाट इन व्हिच ईयर द वर्नाकुलर प्रेस एक्ट पास्ड 1935. Amritpal, your answer? 34. Next by? 1900? 1904. Shantanu. Then you? Yeah. 1921. Then you? 1878. Vernacular Press Act enacted in 1878. I gave you the opportunity to right, use your right to expression. So that was as a positive point of independence because during British age, people can't express in society. But after the independence, people can express in society against or in favor of the government. But The condition is there, as according to the constitution, our words, it shouldn't hurt the sentiments of any community, person, or authority. We can express no doubt, but our word, the uttered words, it shouldn't hurt the sentiments of anybody. Clear? So happy Independence Day. Anybody want to say something regarding the independence? Anybody else? Anybody want to say anything? Happy Independence Day to everybody.
Thank you, sir. Same to you, sir.
Amritpal, kuch kehna? Jasleen, yeah. Use your right to expression. Thank you. Kuch toh ka. Thank you.
Happy Independence.
मैंने कहा 1931 में जब पूना पैक्ट साइन हुआ उस दिन पंडित नेहरू डिसाइडेड एज एट सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ अ फर्स्ट इंडिपेंडेंस डे 26 जनवरी 1931 ठीक है ना वो डे सेट किया गया पर उस दिन इंडिपेंडेंस सेलिब्रेट नहीं हुई देन आफ्टरवर्ड्स आफ्टर द इंडिपेंडेंस व्हेन इन 1949 26 नवंबर 1949 द ड्राफ्ट ऑफ अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एक्सेप्टेड बाय द पार्लियामेंट अप्रूव्ड बाय द पार्लियामेंट देन आफ्टरवर्ड्स द डे स्टार्टेड टू डिसाइड व्हिच ऑफ द डे विल बी एज द रिपब्लिक डे ऑफ इंडिया देन दिस मेमोराइज दैट डे व्हिच अर्लियर अनाउंस्ड बाय द पंडित नेहरू एज द सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट इंडिपेंडेंस डे 26 जनवरी डिसाइड किया गया 26 नवंबर को कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बन चुका था अप्रूव हो चुका था कि वही कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इंप्लीमेंट होगा उसको आफ्टर टू मंथ्स ऑन 26 जनवरी 1950 इट इंप्लीमेंटेड ओवर इंडियंस वो डे के लिए 26 जनवरी के लिए फ्रेमर्स ऑफ अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे दे मेक एज अ मेमोरी और अ कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ अ सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ दैट डे विच प्रायर Announced by the Pandit Nehru as celebration of first Independence Day, जो 26 जनवरी 1931 को decide किया गया था, उसकी memory के लिए वो दिन दिया गया, Indian Republic के लिए, हाँ जी, I think 2 months, 26 November को Constitution approve कर दिया था Parliament ने, approve means pass कर दिया था, वो Constitution ही लगेगा, after 2 months, 26 January 1950. Total 273 members were there in a constituent assembly, which framed the constitution of India. Punjab mein 1948. No idea. Poor information, wrong information.